Statehood. States are the fundamental or primary subject of international law. This is because they are the international entities which, besides controlling territory in a stable and permanent way, exercise the lawmaking and executive functions of any legal order. States are the backbone of the international community. They possess full legal capacity, that is to say, they have the ability to be vested with rights, powers and obligations under international law. The definition of a state under international law is not clear because quite often it is difficult to decide whether a particular entity is or is not a state. Brownlie says that a state is a type of legal person recognized by international law, although the possession of legal personality is not in itself a sufficient mark of statehood. However, he states that the criteria of statehood are laid down by the law because if it were not so, then statehood would be subjective, such that a state would be able to contract out of duties owed to another state simply by refusing to characterize the obligee as a state. He does not, however, state what a state is, but proceeds to look at the characteristics of statehood. The starting point for the definition of statehood is Article 1 of the 1933 Montevideo Convention on Rights and Duties of States, which enumerates what are now widely accepted as characteristics of statehood in international law. The article provides that the states, as a person of international law, should possess the following qualifications: a. A permanent population, b. A defined territory, c. A government, and d. Capacity to enter into relations with other states. These enumerations should be noted as not exhaustive but merely a basis for further investigations, because not all the qualifications are final. The criteria have been clarified and developed by international law, especially by jurists who, on the basis of state practice, have identified further evidence that must be considered in the criteria for statehood. Permanent population. A state cannot exist without a population. The requirement for a permanent population refers to a politically stable community. There is no prescribed legal minimum number of people making up the number of population. For instance, the Vatican City has an estimated resident population of 750, Tiny Nauru has a population of 20,000, and the Maldives Island has a population of 350,000. The criterion of population is not affected if the population of a state is nomadic. Besides, international law does not require the population to be homogeneous. The criterion of a stable community refers to a group of individuals living within a certain geographical area. Defined territory. A fixed territory constitutes a basic requirement for statehood. The stable political community must be in control of a certain area. The criterion of territory is connected with that of permanent population and constitutes the physical basis for the existence of a state. There is no requirement that the frontiers of the state be fully defined or undisputed either at the time it comes into being or subsequently. For instance, the State of Israel was admitted to the United Nations in 1949, although the final delimitation of its boundary had not been settled. What is important is the effect of establishment of a political community within an identifiable territory. International law does not require any minimum size of a territory. For instance, the Vatican occupies only 0.44 square kilometers, Nauru in the South Pacific occupies 8 square miles, while the Principality of Monaco is a sovereign state forming an enclave of French territory and covering an area of 105 hectares, of which 35% has been claimed from the sea. Neither does international require geographical unity of the territory. The state may consist of territorial areas but are separated and distinct from each other. What is needed is unity under a common legal system. For instance, the Republic of Kiribati is an archipelagic state comprising several islands, some of which are as far as 1,000 km from the other. Government. A government or at least some governmental control is required for qualification of an entity as a state. The existence of an effective and independent government with centralized administrative and legislative organs is generally the best evidence of a stable political community. In certain cases, however, the presence of effective government alone is insufficient to support statehood. But once a government has been established, The absence of governmental authority does not affect the existing state's right to be considered as a state. This is because states have often survived periods of anarchy, civil war, and hostile occupation. However, in order for a territory which has not already achieved the status of a state to be considered as such, it must have a government of its own and not be subject to the control of another state. In other words, a puppet state is not a state in international law. Capacity to enter into relations with other states, although the new entity may have a government capable of acting on its behalf, in order for its claim to be a state to succeed, the entity itself must be capable of entering into relations with other states. The capacity of an entity to enter into relations with other states derives from the control the government exercises over a given territory, which in turn is based on the actual independence of that state. The state must be independent of other states' legal orders or any international agency and must be based on a title of international law. International law identifies two elements evidencing the existence of independence. The first is that the entity exists separately within established boundaries. This emphasizes the link between territory, population, government, and independence. The second is that the entity is not subject to any other authority except international law. Accordingly, if an entity has its own executive and other organs, conducts its foreign relations through its own organs, has its own legal system and nationality law, then there is prima facie evidence of statehood. External control through political and economic blackmail directed at weaker members of international community does not affect statehood.